Every person you've ever known, every moment in human history, unfolded on a planet just 12,742 kilometers wide, barely a cosmic speck against the vastness of space. Yet that speck orbits a sun so distant, it takes light 8 minutes to reach us. Beyond that, the numbers spiral into billions. This is no exaggeration. The observable universe stretches across 93 billion light years, a scale so massive the mind can't grasp its boundaries. If how massive is our universe is the question, then the real challenge is understanding just how impossibly small we really are. What lies between our tiny blue world and the true edge of the cosmos? The journey begins right here on Earth. Earth, a sphere just 12,742 kilometers wide, spins beneath an ocean of air and cloud. For all of human history, this planet has been both cradle and boundary. Yet the first true measure of our place in the cosmos came not from philosophy, but from a journey across the void. In December 1968, Apollo 8 carried three astronauts farther from home than anyone before. As their spacecraft looped behind the moon, the crew caught a glimpse that would forever alter humanity's perspective. Earth, rising above the gray lunar horizon, a blue and white marble suspended in blackness. Bill Anders scrambled to capture the moment, snapping the photograph that became known as Earthrise. From that vantage, every mountain, city, and memory fit within a single thumbprint of color. The distance they traveled, 384,000 kilometers, stretched farther than all previous human exploration combined. To bridge that gap by car, driving nonstop at highway speed, would take more than 5 months. Even a jet plane racing through the sky at 900 kilometers per hour would spend nearly 3 weeks to reach the moon. Yet in cosmic terms, this is only the first step outward. Beyond the moon, the scale of our solar neighborhood begins to reveal itself. The Sun, the blazing heart of our system, sits 150 million kilometers from Earth, a distance so immense that astronomers use it as a measuring stick, calling it one astronomical unit. Light itself, traveling at nearly 300,000 kilometers per second, spends 8 minutes and 20 seconds making the journey from Sun to Earth. Every sunrise is a message sent across that gulf. If you tried to cross it in a commercial jet, the trip would last 19 years. For all its warmth and brilliance, the sun is both our lifeline and a reminder of the emptiness between worlds. Even here, within the inner solar system, the numbers begin to slip beyond everyday comprehension. Yet this is only the beginning. The distances ahead will dwarf even these first staggering steps. Mars, the red wanderer, circles the sun on a tilted path that never quite matches our own. At its closest, the gap between Earth and Mars narrows to about 54.6 million kilometers, a gulf so wide that even a commercial jet would need half a century to cross it, flying nonstop, day and night. When the planets drift to opposite sides of the Sun, that distance swells to 401 million kilometers, a moving target that has confounded every mission planner and robotic explorer. Each journey to Mars is a leap across a shifting, invisible bridge where the timing of launch windows and the precision of orbital mechanics decide success or failure. Beyond Mars, the solar system's true scale becomes impossible to ignore. Jupiter, the largest of the planets, lies 778 million kilometers from the Sun. Saturn's rings sweep through space at 1.4 billion kilometers, and Uranus, pale blue and distant, orbits at nearly 2.9 billion kilometers. Neptune, the outermost giant, spins in darkness 4.5 billion kilometers from our star. Sunlight, racing at the fastest speed nature allows, takes more than 4 hours to reach Neptune's cloud tops. Even here, inside our own solar family, the emptiness between worlds is so vast that numbers alone begin to lose their meaning. Yet human ambition presses outward. In 1977, Voyager 1 launched from Earth, carrying with it a golden record, a message in 55 languages, music from Bach to Chuck Berry, and the heartbeat of a woman in love. Over four decades later, Voyager 1 has traveled more than 22 billion kilometers, moving at 61,000 kilometers per hour. It is now the most distant object ever made by human hands, a silent envoy drifting through the darkness. In 1990, at Carl Sagan's urging, Voyager turned its camera back toward home. The image it captured, Earth as a pale blue dot suspended in a shaft of sunlight, reminded us how small and precious our world truly is. And still, Voyager has not yet left the sun's domain. Far beyond the planets, a shell of icy bodies forms the Oort cloud, the solar system's final frontier. The Oort cloud may stretch nearly 100,000 astronomical units from the sun, almost 2 light-years, or 1/5 the distance to the nearest star. Here, the sun's influence fades, and interstellar space begins. Even at Voyager's relentless pace, it would take another 300 years just to reach the inner edge. The scale of our home system, from Mars to the Oort cloud, is a testament to both the limits of our reach and the boundlessness of our curiosity. Between the Oort cloud and the next sun lies a gulf so wide that even light, the universe's speed limit, spends more than 4 years crossing it. The Alpha Centauri system, our closest stellar neighbor, sits 4.37 light-years away, a distance that turns the fastest spacecraft ever built into a frozen relic. At Voyager 1's pace, the journey would last over 70,000 years. Proxima Centauri, a faint red star orbiting alongside Alpha Centauri A and B, hosts at least one planet in its habitable zone, yet remains utterly unreachable for now. These are not just numbers, they are reminders of our cosmic isolation. Within this darkness, human presence is a brief spark. Every radio broadcast since Marconi's first signal in 1895 has traveled outward at light speed, forming an expanding bubble about 100 light-years across. Beyond this sphere, the rest of the galaxy remains unaware of our existence. The Milky Way itself stretches 100,000 light-years from end to end, a spiral disk home to more than 200 billion stars. Our solar system orbits in a quiet arm about 27,000 light-years from the galactic center. At the heart of the Milky Way lurks Sagittarius. A star, a supermassive black hole with 4 million times the mass of the Sun. Its gravity binds the galaxy, shaping the orbits of stars and clouds of gas. Yet the galaxy's true heft cannot be explained by what we see. Vera Rubin's work revealed that stars at the edges spin faster than visible mass allows. Something unseen, dark matter, outweighs all the shining stars and planets, making up the bulk of the Milky Way's mass. Most of our galaxy is invisible, its structure held together by a mystery as old as the cosmos itself. Galaxies gather in patterns shaped by gravity's silent hand. The Milky Way and Andromeda, just two members of the local group, are bound together, with Andromeda sitting 2.5 million light-years away on a collision course with our own. This small cluster is itself part of the Virgo supercluster, a region 110 million light-years across. Yet Virgo is only a tributary feeding into Laniakea, a supercluster stretching 500 million light-years and containing over 100,000 galaxies. All of these are drawn toward the Great Attractor, a gravitational anomaly whose pull bends the paths of entire galaxy clusters, revealing a universe built from vast rivers and filaments of matter. Astronomers map these flows by tracking the motion of galaxies, each one steered by the hidden mass of dark matter and the relentless tug of gravity. At this scale, galaxies become islands, superclusters form continents, and the cosmic web stretches beyond imagination. At the farthest edge lies a boundary set by light's reach. The observable universe forms a sphere 93 billion light-years wide, its edge defined by the distance light has traveled since the Big Bang. In 1965, Arno Penzias and Robert Wilson, tuning a radio antenna, caught the faint hiss of the cosmic microwave background, the oldest light, a relic from when the universe was just 380,000 years old. Beyond this, space expands faster than light can travel, driven by dark energy, a force making up nearly 70% of the cosmos. Here, the visible universe ends, but the structure continues, unreachable and immense. The observable universe spans 93 billion light years, as confirmed by precise measurements and satellite data. We have traced our journey from the 384,000 kilometer gap to the Moon, past Voyager 1's 22 billion kilometer odyssey, to galaxies millions of light years away. Along the way, discoveries like the cosmic microwave background and dark energy have revealed that most of the universe's content remains invisible and poorly understood. Key questions, such as the true extent of the universe and the exact nature of dark matter, are still unanswered, despite decades of investigation and missions like Planck and Hubble. What the evidence shows is clear. Earth is a tiny, unique outpost in a vast cosmos. Our technologies have mapped only a fraction of what exists, and most of the universe lies beyond current detection. In all documented history, every human achievement has occurred on this single, fragile planet. If the universe is this massive, our role, documented and real, remains a remarkable chapter within an ongoing story still being written.